One of the visits that we're doing today is we're going to go back to one of the first sites that installed some grease trapping equipment and have a conversation with them about how they're finding the unit. So it's really important that we do a visit to each establishment because every single kitchen is different. Different businesses will have different practices in place. And until we've been to site and understand what they're doing and what equipment is in that kitchen, we don't really know what we're faced with. Afternoon, Ian. How are you?
You all right?
Yeah, good. Good to see you again.
Good to see you.
How are you?
Yeah, not too bad.
Good. So the grease trap's installed now?
Yeah.
Excellent.
It's all done.
Brilliant. So it's been in for a couple of weeks now?
Yeah.
Had the unit in. Have you found it so far?
It's really
been a surprise.
Hell of a surprise. Shown me as a chef how much oil, fat, grease comes through just everyday residue, plates. It's really surprising.
And that's the biggest challenge that we find, that businesses are doing the right thing. They're dry wiping plates, they're using strainers.
Yeah.
They can do everything they can to get the bulk
yeah.
of the fat, oil and grease off the plates,
yeah.
the pots and the pans, but it's that residual that over yeah. time, multiplied in a town as well, has a huge impact on the
yeah.
sewer network.
I think we felt like we needed to play our part and get one installed. Always scrape any fat, any grease into the bin, into a container, but the residue fat off, like butter or anything like that, oil from mayonnaise, it just stays on the plate but then goes down the drain and clogs the drains up, and you don't see that. So by having the machine installed, you get to see what oil is coming out of the everyday dishes, cooking, and the amount that you get to pull back into a container. You feel like you've done your job.
So crucially and hopefully you are getting some money back from your collection company for this.
Yep, that's
brilliant.
It. Yeah, it all goes towards buying some more oil.
Fantastic, because as they say, there's money in waste, and obviously this fuel will go back into the circular economy. It can be used for things like biofuels, it goes to be recycling, which again has an environmental impact. So education is key. It's arguably the most important thing to not just change people's behaviour, but also to sustain that change. So putting the grease trap in is the first step, but without maintenance of that grease trap, then we're going to be back to square one. Fat, oil and grease in the sewer network starts to solidify, it starts to harden, clings to the outside of the pipes, and it restricts the flow down to such point that the wastewater and the sewage simply can't pass forward. So the issues that you get with that is then a blockage in the first instance, where the pipe is simply completely blocked, and that sewage is going to have to back up somewhere. It doesn't just stop flowing because the pipe's blocked, and ultimately it's going to find a way to escape out, and often that is through the form of a flooding event, so an internal or an external flooding. So we've got a wet well there that is absolutely caked on the top, real thick crust of fat. Small catchment again for
yeah.
four businesses perhaps.
Yeah.
And that is the effect. People hear the word Fatberg and they immediately think of London, and they think of sewers that are big enough to drive a double-decker bus through. Now the reality is most of the sewers that our guys are working on are 150mm, 225mm, so smaller than a dinner plate. I think radical change, real radical change, is only going to be achieved through the combined effort of all the food service establishments in the region. It's those small steps that are going to have a massive effect on the sewer network. What I would say to the individual businesses that don't think they're causing a problem is you may not be aware of the issue you're causing, and if you haven't caused an issue yet, that first incident could be the one that leads to a significant pollution event. We particularly are calling for the help of the hospitality and the food service sector to keep the community and the areas they serve essentially free from fat, oil and grease and environmental risk.